Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with one of Intel's workhorse servers, the Intel Server System M50CYP2UR208. It's designed to support a number of business-critical workloads, including storage, database, uses a web server, for e-commerce, data analytics, and some high-performance computing workloads. This 2U server is part of Intel's single-node server category and boasts third-generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors. It can field up to 24 hybrid drive bays supporting SAS, SATA, or NVMe drive formats, and can support up to 12 terabytes of memory using Intel's Optane persistent 200 series memory modules. First off, the one thing that was definitely not user-friendly was finding information on this system on Intel's site. Each manufacturer does do things differently, but this almost seemed intentionally embedded and disjointed. It is part of the M50CYP2UR family of servers, formerly codenamed Coyote Creek or Coyote Ugly or something like that without the attractive women. Our chassis is the M50CYP2UR208, but you would never know that because it doesn't say that anywhere on the system. Yes, we did order this system with that name, but come on! How about some branding, model numbers, you know, like standard marketing practices? But enough of that. It supports up to 24 2.5-inch drives in front, and there is another system that supports 12 3.5-inch drives, the M50CYP2UR312, and two more in the family at 1U that are also defined by the supported storage. At least there is some kind of rationale behind this naming convention. Let's dig in. This platform can be configured with 8, 16, or 24 SAS, SATA, or NVMe drives, and of course any number in between, depending on how it's ultimately configured. The left server area has two USB ports, one is a 2.0 port and the other a 3.0 port. A control panel on the right has a power on button with integrated LED and system ID button next to that with integrated LED light too. A system cold reset button and a non-maskable interrupt button, which both require a pin or paperclip to use, and below those, a system status and drive activity LED. All drive bays have LEDs for activity and status. Are you interested in this system? Because if you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system listed on our site, or one that you can configure that's listed at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to get even more information on this particular system. If you see what you like, remember to mention you watched this video to reap the rewards of your labors, kind of like the seven labors of Hercules. But I can't even remember now what he actually got. It's probably not even close, actually. On the back of the system, there are 8 PCIe slots corresponding to the 3 risers inside. A PSU to either side allows fresh air to run right down the center of the chassis and prevents heat buildup by separating them instead of stacking them one on top of the other. The PSU options include 1300 watt, 1600 watt, and 2100 watt with the highest power supply recommended when the system is configured with GPUs. Along the bottom, a video port, remote management port, serial port, a OCP 3.0 mezzanine card slot, and 3 USB 3.0 ports. The dedicated management port accesses an ASPEED AST2500 server management baseboard controller for at chassis and remote management of the system. It offers integrated video, KVM support, redirection, fan speed control, and voltage monitoring. Also available to manage the server is Intel Server Manager software, which provides continuous health monitoring and asset inventory. The BMC is IPMI 2.0 and Redfish compliant for Windows and Linux-based operating systems. No surprises there. Additionally, Intel's Data Center Manager or DCM console helps with power monitoring and thermal management in data centers. This family of servers is also certified with Nutanix Enterprise Cloud, VMware vSAN, and Microsoft Azure Stack HCI, and can be delivered as Intel data center blocks, drastically reducing time to deployment and reducing risk with a number of pre-tested configurations. The cover panel is removed in two sections. Inside, you can see a logical layout with drive cage, 6 60mm fans, and dual CPU sockets, each in charge of 8 memory module slots to either side for a total of 32 active memory module slots with both processors installed. You can go with just a single processor, but you will only have access to half the goods on the system, including the memory and those PCI slots in the back. With third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors installed on this system, supported memory includes standard, registered, and load reduced, plus the 3DS varieties, which have a higher density of DRAM modules and persistent memory series 200 modules. 3DS RDIMMs or LRDIMMs will provide up to 8 terabytes, while the PMEM 200 series at full capacity when paired with RDIMMs will provide up to 12 terabytes of memory. Previous generation PMEM series 100 are not supported. PMEM modules provide a performance boost for in-memory analytics and database applications, plus content delivery networks. Think video streaming. and high-performance computing applications. With PMEM, you have two options, Direct App Mode and Memory Mode. Direct App Mode treats the memory modules like SSD storage devices that are closer to the CPU for improved data caching. Memory Mode, which does offer increased memory capacity, but all memory is volatile, meaning there is no persistence. You can only utilize the persistence feature in Direct App Mode. The third generation Intel Xeon Scalable processors provide 8 memory channels per CPU. Also PCIe 4.0 with 64 PCIe lanes per CPU for 128 PCIe 4.0 lanes with both processors installed. That's a significant increase over the 96 lanes available in a dual processor configuration using previous generation scalable CPUs. The thermal design power listed on this platform is 270 watts, which includes the entire range of Intel Xeon Scalable processors with a few exceptions. Another feature is 3 UltraPath interconnects or UPI delivering enhanced I/O between processors for Platinum and Gold series scalable processors. Platinum, Gold 6300 or 5300 series, or Silver categories each provide different maximum core counts. With the third generation CPUs, Bronze series processors have been discontinued, at least so far. Platinum processors provide the highest core count at up to 40 physical cores and up to 80 virtual threads using Intel's hyper-threading technology. Gold processors will provide up to 32 cores maximum, while Silver delivers up to 22 cores. Platinum and Gold 6300 series processors also support the fastest memory modules with speeds of up to 3200 megahertz. A standard heatsink is included with the system, but if accelerators or GPGPUs are installed, a standard 1U heatsink is required, along with a GPU air duct and bracket, plus a few other hardware bits. Storage up front is allocated with 3 separate backplanes, each supporting up to 8 2.5 inch SAS, SATA, or NVMe SSD drives. The backplanes support a 64 gigabit per second interface for U.2 NVMe, 12 gigabit per second for SAS, and 6 gigabit per second for SATA drive formats, all hot swap compatible. Supported drive configurations include SAS or SATA only, NVMe only, or a combination of both SAS and NVMe drives. The backplane features 4 PCIe 4.0 x 8 slim SAS connectors on the bottom, each of which connects to 2 NVMe U.2 drives on the other side. 2 multi-port mini SAS HD cable connectors on top provide signals for up to 4 SAS or SATA devices each. In this case, all of them are out to a SAS expander board mounted between the backplane and fans. Optionally, the PCIe connectors can be routed to a tri-mode controller or to an NVMe riser card with slim SAS connectors. The system can also be outfitted with an internal fixed mount solid state drive support with 2 SSD drive bays that installs just above the PSU on the right hand side. 2 PCIe by 4 slots on the system board can be outfitted with M.2 NVMe drives for additional super fast storage or to support the OS. They can also be rated together in mirror mode for redundancy using either a premium or standard Intel VROC key. An OCP network adapter mezzanine slot in the back of the chassis conforms with the Open Compute Project OCP 3.0 specification and can be installed in an OCP mezzanine card slot on the end of the server board. The OCP card is installed in the back of the chassis just by removing a small cover plate and without removing the cover panel on the server. You get connection and bandwidth options with that OCP 3.0 card too. For GPU installation, the riser cards will support a x16 mechanical and electrical lane with the slot providing up to 75 watts of power. 2 supplemental 12-volt power connectors on the system provide up to 225 watts of additional power to cards that exceed the 75-watt maximum power provided by the slot. Assuming I did my math right, this system should support 2 300-watt GPUs. I mean, it doesn't specifically mention which GPUs have been vetted on this system or how many, like anywhere in the documentation. That would include the integration and service guide, the technical guide, the product family system and integration and service guide, and the M50CYP family configuration guide. Until further notice, let's just go with that number. 2. Furthermore, I suspect it will support the GPUs of choice from NVIDIA, like the A100 40GB and 80GB versions, plus that new one with the Ada Lovelace architecture. This system will support a variety of I/O devices, and I would suspect PCIe mounted SSD drives too, depending on your business needs, how it's configured, and thermal constraints. Aside from the hard-to-find information on the 2U Intel Server System M50CYP2UR208, there's no denying that it delivers some powerful performance. As one of Intel's workhorse servers, are we supposed to expect anything less? I think not. If you're looking for a server, workstation, processors, memory, storage, GPUs, or some critical component to keep your network from imploding, then check out itcreations.com. Chances are we have what you're looking for, and if we don't, we can get it. Since we're located on the West Coast, you can think of us as your last bastion of hope. Till next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. And remember, if it ain't broke, that doesn't necessarily mean it's not time to replace it.